Okay guys, these doors are the factory installation if you were to buy the kit to put the doors on. And Jim Robinson here at Erie, Illinois has a great way to trim this out to hide all of the rivets and aluminum. And what it does is it dresses up the door, and I'll show you his door here in a few minutes. I had it on my other plane, and it just really dresses it up nice, makes it look substantial, and just gives it a very clean finished look. Now the first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna wanna clean this plastic, this Lexan. And what we do is we use a product called Sparkle. Now this isn't an endorsement for Sparkle, but what we found is, and what Jim has found over the years, is Sparkle doesn't leave residue and it doesn't streak, it doesn't scratch and damage the Lexan. So it's what he recommends to use only on Lexan, not Windex or other products. And then he recommends also, when you clean, you go in one direction, don't swirl, because the swirl leaves swirl marks. And so what we're gonna do is I'm gonna bring Jim in, and he's gonna kind of explain what he's gonna do here, and then we'll show you his printing method and the product he uses, and we'll go from there.
All right, good morning, this is Jim. I'm helping up the Mr. Bean here, getting his windows, his doors dressed up. This product here is a typical vinyl sign painter's tape. You get it at just about any sign shop across the country carries it, and you're just going to go into the shop and ask them if they could rip you some of this inch and a half wide. And of course you take a piece of their samples out and you match it up. This is not a perfect match, but the other one we got is too orange, so we're going to go with this one here. I think once you get it on the door, you'll be happy with it. Now we're going to cut the stuff an inch and a half wide. Should be enough to cover all our rivets and edges. We're going to put a piece in the corner and we'll round that off, and then we're going to finish off with a thin black pinstripe around here this way. And if you take a look at my doors, you can see what a finished door will look like. See, we're just going to take the, instead of yellow, his will be red vinyl going on here like this, and we'll trim it, and then we'll go ahead and stick our black vinyl on top of it. And heating it with a heat gun makes these rivet heads pull down to where they look like they've almost been painted instead of just plastic. So let's go in the shop and we'll cut some vinyl. Now this is a vinyl sign cutting system. We do the artwork over here on the computer and feed it through a thing to the cutter over here on the table, and that's going to cut our vinyl. This is doesn't have to be red on the screen, it just happened to be the color it's on today. So
what program do you use?
I'm using a program called FlexiSign. They use Corel Draw. There's a lot of different sign programs that'll do this. Each sign shop will want to use their own, and I'll take the layout, get rid of the fills, so you can see this is actually, instead of a solid red piece, these are several pieces of they'll be cut into strips of vinyl, and each one of them looks like it's each one is about 36 inches long, an inch and a half wide.
Okay.
And basically we say, okay, let's cut it. And we're gonna select all this and send it to the cutter and say cut plot. And it comes up the cut plot. We've already got our vinyl loaded and our cutter's set, and your sign guy will take care of all that for you. And all we gotta do is just cut this, or we hit the command to cut, and it'll start cutting our window strips.
About how much does it take per door, you think?
Okay, we're done cutting. So
okay.
The machine is finished cutting our first set of stripes, and we're going to take them off and get started with this project.
Okay.
You'll need about 20 strips, inch and a half wide by 36 inches. Just get your old trusty X-Acto knife out, or stop at Walmart and get one if you don't have it, and just grab the corner of the tape like this and pick it up. Comes off of there. And we're going to stick this now. You really don't need a squeegee to put this down. You can just use your fingertips like I just did here. Just make sure you get each one of the rivets covered. And
you need to have some room temperature to do this, though. You don't want to do
it. Yeah, I wouldn't do it outside where it's cold. Okay. It never works. I've done it in people's hangers before. Didn't get a real good adhesion. So and that's our first strip that goes on. And we just keep laying them on. We'll need a short piece to put on right here. And to make a short piece, just take one of the longer pieces you got here. We have plenty. We're going to cut it in half.
So what we're doing is we're loading the black, and the black is going to be the quarter inch trim that goes around the red just to finish it up. And Jim was saying that probably about $150 is what a roll of this material would cost. And so it might be cost prohibitive for you guys to go out and buy a roll of red and a roll of black or a roll of tan and a roll of green.
One roll like this, a 100 yard roll or something, that's probably $300. But that would do probably,
yeah.
Airplane.
Sure, sure.
You only need, like I said, you're going to need two rolls like this and a little bit of black and you're done.
Yeah. So. But if you're in a group and there's five of you or six of you, then it might be, you know, but if you guys wanted to get together and all go in and buy a roll, that would be a little bit better. But like Jim says, by the time you buy everything, you can just about pay a little bit of markup to a sign guy and have him whip it out for you. Yeah.
Wheel pants cool.
There you go. On the landing gear somewhere. I've got.
By the way, this is a good way to show them how it actually cuts letters. And
yeah. I've got those.
Sticking out right here, see that?
Okay.
So you can either take and trim that off.
Probably so it looks uneven, it looks wavy.
Yeah, and like, that way you got a nice straight edge there.
Uh-huh.
Or you can leave it on, because when it's on the plane like this, you stand back,
you don't
nobody's
see it.
It looks like a shadow.
Yeah.
Nobody's
so what you were telling me was, when you put this tape on, if there's an air bubble, you just work those air bubbles to the rivets,
yep.
And then as you manipulate your finger around the rivet, and then when you put heat to it, then it's going to tighten right up to that rivet.
These down here, I just push it up around like this, and
gotcha.
Get them all in there so they're nice and tight and snug, and then you trim off our edges here.
Mm-hmm. You've got about 10 minutes tops so far in this project.
Yeah, you know, once you got your vinyl there, it shouldn't take you more than an hour or so to do each door.
To do each door, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now we're going to put a little more tape here to close up this piece, but we'll just add that when we have some scrap left over from another part of the plane. What I want to do now is these corner sections and show you how those are done.
Okay. So you just square it off initially.
Yeah, and it's not real high tech. I just
right.
take a piece that I cut off a little extra, and I lay it up here like this, and press it down. And I take a sharp X-Acto knife, and I trim off the edges there, because I don't want it all stacked up too much.
Oh, a buildup of tape. Gotcha.
Yeah, I don't want a big buildup
of big
tape
build-up.
There, you know.
Yeah.
And now this is the tricky part. If you want to, you can lay a roll of duct tape up there and curve it, or you can get a baby jar lid or something.
Uh-huh.
I just freehand cut it. I put the X-Acto knife like this, and I start here, and I just make a curve up this way, and I end it here. And that's how I make the corners. Come on up there, you.
This stuff's pretty thin, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, this stuff, people are asking how much weight does it add to the doors. And, you know, this whole thing of...
You'll clean more dirt off the glass probably than you did in the tape away.
If you wash the glass, you probably lose as much dirt as the tape weighs.
Right.
Now I'll put another piece on here like this here in this corner.
How long, Jim, do you think that this tape would last if you keep the plane hangered and you take care of the plane?
It'll outlast your Lexan.
Okay, so you'll change out the Lexan doors.
Yeah, your Lexan will get scratched up and stuff
before you would ever need to change out the
this
tape.
This is actually what most sign shops use what they call a 7-year vinyl,
uh-huh.
which means it'll last out in the sun for 7 years.
Wow.
Before it ever starts to shrink or crack.
So it's got some UV protectant in it.
Right, yeah, it's good stuff, so. There you go. It's very thin. By the way, those that when you buy a new Challenger kit and you get the decals and it say Challenger that you stick on the side of your airplane, it's the same type of tape right here.
Okay.
And in fact, I make those for the Challenger factory, so I know where they come
from. You know where they come from, yeah.
Yeah. Now, let's see. We're going to do the finish up this bottom stretch, and then we're going to do the leading edge. And what we cut off the leading edge, because you got two pieces coming together here. So you're going to have about 3/4 inch on this side and 3/4 inch on this side.
To create the same standard
and
width.
And I'll get the standard width you got going here, like gotcha. This all the way around. So this piece that we cut off then, I'll bring back here and fill in this trailing edge right here so we don't lose our tight seal behind the window there, right. Okay? So I'm going to put one more piece on the bottom there.
Now, does this vinyl come in, I mean, can you just literally get almost any shade of red, or is it just primary colors? Or?
Right, when you're building airplanes and you look at the catalogs and stuff, they got maybe 14 different colors of paint you can buy.
Uh-huh.
These vinyl sections like this, you can get this in about 3,000 different colors and
okay.
shades.
So you could special order whatever color for your sign person, and then give them the material and have them, or they could probably.
Here's something I always think about too. You know, if you're painting your plane with a custom color, you could buy your vinyl first if you're going to use red vinyl.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, you could buy the red vinyl
and match the paint,
and take it to the paint shop and have them match their paint
to the vinyl.
Yeah.
And then it's a much more accurate.
Right. And then it's exactly right. But you know, most guys, you know, close enough is good enough.
The decals become the afterthought of the main project.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
There again, I've only got about an 1/8 inch overlap there.
Gotcha.
But you can see how easy this is to do. I always tell people that, you know, if they fly their airplane in here sometime to my airport and they want to do this, you know, we can probably get it done.
Couple hours, have it whipped out.
Yeah, get it done while they're sitting here having a Pepsi or something.
Yeah,
get all this vinyl cut and put on for them.
Your only caveat would be if their Lexan's starting to get pretty worn and needing changed, you'd recommend them swap out the Lexan first.
Go ahead and change your Lexan first and get your new Lexan on, and then put this on. And, and you can trim everything.
Just makes the doors look so much beefier, substantial, like there's framework, you know, that I remember talking to Dave Burra, who was a Missouri dealer for Challenger, and he always commented about how he liked your doors, the work that you did on the doors to make them look finished, you know, so.
When you publish this, the secret's out, and everybody will be able to do it to their planes.
Or come see
you. It's going to be hard to do, and then actually, now when I'm doing this here, what I'm doing is I'm going to lay my tape right along the edge of that aluminum tube. That's my marker spot. So I'm going to lay this up here and give it a little bit of an overlap, and we're just going to stick half of it down.
And that's because you're at a...
Yeah, I'm at that point where I want this to look the same width as this when I'm done. So...
And 36 inches is manageable. That's why you like that length.
Yeah, I do. You could make it 4 feet long if you wanted to, and you have fewer seams. But 36 inches is manageable, and it'll more than adequate to work. Because you know your Lexan windshields and stuff, in normal wear and tear, are going to last you. They're going to last you probably 2 or 3 years.
Yeah.
So when you take them off and use them as a pattern to build your new windshield. This over here. Now you can use, you don't have to use an X-Acto knife, you could use a straight edge razor blade and do the same thing. But
Now, as a side note, Jim, you were telling me that you've got a supplier that can make custom seats. And that's what you've got sitting in the plane here. Now, minus the Challenger that's written, that's embroidered on them, monogrammed on them, can a person order those in different colors through you, or do you offer those in black only?
Yeah, we can. I had a guy just ask me today. I seen a note on my Facebook page. The guy was wanting to know if he could get red seats. And I said, well, you can, but, you know, there's a lot of different shades of red. And
yeah.
You might order red vinyl seats and then have the seats finished up looking more like orange when you put them against your red plane.
Uh-huh.
Like I like about black, it's pretty universal when
right.
it comes to... Now, see, this piece that we put on that we cut off the windshield catches this back edge here, so we don't have to cut it off now.
Right.
And we got that all covered nice and neat. And
So if somebody's looking for some new seats, they can give you a holler and you can...
Yeah, we can work something out for them and stuff. They're basically going to be $400 a pair.
$400 a pair.
Or $200 if you got a single seat Challenger.
Uh-huh.
This seat here fits great in a single place Challenger.
It looks great.
Lighter.
Yeah.
And we can get those made up for you. My problem is right now is I've got to check with my sign or my seat guy. Somebody told me the other day they think he went back to Mexico. And I don't know if that meant for a family vacation or if he just moved his shop back. If he did, I will find another supplier because I do like these seats and I got a lot of people asking questions about it.
But you can't guarantee the price if you have to go to a different supplier.
I'm going
to
try to get a supplier that will make them for me where I can hold the line at $400.
Gotcha.
So,
okay.
Now you see, we just about got the whole windshield or the whole side door here.
Yeah.
Finished out. One more trimming here and there.
And then you'll do the windshield, right?
Yeah.
Then you trim out the windshield and that'll...
I usually do the windshield, I'll do it in short sections because of the way you got to contour it.
Uh-huh.
And this vinyl will stretch. So when I do the windshield here, we got a little black tape on there right now. But usually what I do, and I think it looks a lot nicer doing this, is I'll just start here like this and lay this down. Kind of stretch it around like this. And use that tape to seal it. Now the problem with doing this right here is, you know, within 6 months or so this tape might crack along here.
Uh-huh.
So you could trim it right along the edge of your windshield if you want, if you got a good tight fit, and eliminate that problem. And then when you put the rest of the tape on, of course we'll trim it with the curve of the windshield so it looks nice and neat.
Right.
Put the little cross up here for a heads up display.
Right.
Okay. Actually got a piece of scrap cut out and used for a bottom door. That's an edge piece we'd normally throw away, but I'm going to go ahead and use it because I just need a half-inch wide piece for a little ways down here.
Right.
And put this on.
So you would recommend then possibly any leftover that they may have, hold on to in case they have a little rivet pop through or they get a scratch on their regular paint, then they can use that tape to...
Yeah, or just to tape up any little thing you might have. So.
Okay. So don't throw away your extra scraps. Hold on to them. You might need them for patch
right
up.
Right now the door's pretty much got the perimeter covered. And that didn't take us, we've probably been on this project.
20 minutes.
Yeah, 20 minutes now.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do is we're going to cut
some black.
Some more corners here.
Okay.
And then we'll cut some black tape out. So I'll put these other corner pieces on like this. And I can see the line on there where the tape overlaps, and I usually cut just above that line a 1/16 of an inch or so.
I see.
Like that. And then we'll round that off. There we go.
It helps when you're a sign painter and an artist. You know? I would end up doing a 6-sided hexagon. Doesn't that look straight? No, it looks awful. Have you ever put together a price point on doing a project like this? Kind of.
You know, I charge, when I'm doing work on people's airplanes, I charge $50 an hour.
Okay.
So if we can get your doors done in an hour, I'd probably charge you $25 for the tape and $50 label. So you're looking at $75.
$75.
And it makes it just a
looks a lot
big,
better.
Big difference on the way your airplane looks. I mean, you know, we're going to
to see a before and after here real soon. And see, we're getting our corners all done.
Yeah. We had the black tape to that. It's real.
And it's really going to pop.
Makes it pop. Especially since the plane already has a black lines on it. That crack.
Yeah, I'm just gonna.
So, years ago, and I still have it, I've actually never used it, but years ago I bought a Cricut, and it was one of those vinyl cutting. Have you ever seen them in the hobby shops?
Sure.
If a guy had his own Cricut hobby cutter, could he potentially do this himself?
Yeah, you could do this yourself with a Cricut. You
know, okay.
You know, I don't know how long the strips you can cut with a Cricut.
I think it's unlimited as long as the roll is,
okay.
You know. But the width isn't as wide as yours. It'll only cut about an 18-inch wide strip, I think, or 24-inch. But a guy could do this himself if he had a plotter.
Yeah, you wouldn't have to. You don't necessarily. It's easy just to go to a sign shop and say, hey, Mr. Sign Guy,
Me
some strips. I need 20 of them,
sure.
Inch and a half long by 3 feet. And he'll walk in the back room and cut them for you. And
whip them out.
I don't imagine it costs more than, it'd be less than $50 for the vinyl, I'm sure. So,
yeah.
You know, I'm thinking, it's not, the vinyl isn't that expensive. So.
Right.
Notice I let my knife fall.
He didn't try to catch it.
Yeah, I quit trying to catch X-Acto knife several stitches ago. See, we got our corners all looking pretty good. Got that one to do in the front corner. Now the front corner, I'm going to take a piece off the end here and use it because it's a pretty good size. So I'm going to put a bigger piece in there. Because I want to cover this whole bottom section here as much as
I
can.
See.
Like that, see.
Mm-hmm. Cover more surface area.
Yeah, actually what I try to do is I get it so I don't have to make a sharper curve down here.
Mm-hmm.
I can just do a gentler curve because you don't want the vinyl to pull up. Now this presses down good here. And just make a little curve in here like this. I mean, you get this vinyl tape, it comes in virtually all colors, so.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see here.
It's really thin.
Mm-hmm. It is. It's just.
I'll edit all that.
It sticks really good.
Yeah. All right.
That sound there ripping is a tight seal.
Tight seal. It is already looking just way different than it did.
Yeah, our next thing is going to be adding the
black pinstripe.
Adding the black pinstripe around there, and that's really what's going to make it pop.
So. Yeah. We'll hold that door for you.
And that finishes the red. That probably took 20 minutes to.
Yeah, 25.
Get it all trimmed out.
Yeah.
Now, when we do the windshield, we're only going to use about a half inch, and I'm just using some scrap off the edge here. It's about a half inch already, so I'm just going to use it. Pick that. And this is going to go on the windshield like this. And then you can see why we have a narrow piece there. And then we put a narrow piece on this.
Oh, yeah.
Like that. And then when you get done, you got your, you know, your same width here as you have.
Yeah, right, your total width then becomes, yeah, there you go, yeah.
And then we put the cap seal on top here. And when we put that cap on, we'll have a piece of here that goes up. And so the cap will go between. Does it go between this and that curved piece, does it, or have you tried it on yet?
I've sat it on there, but I haven't tried.
Okay. Well, we'll work with
Yeah, I haven't
but
tried
we'll to. We'll put our tape on there. We'll make the same kind of corner we have here that we have right here going around the top of the window. And the same thing down here where we transition.
Finish that off.
Finish putting this around.
Okay.
And this would be up to you, too, if you want to cut this or leave it stuck down.
You're saying most people will come along and cut that out?
Yeah, because
I've already got
one.
It
will crack.
Yeah.
But mine cracks all the time, and I just put more. I just keep putting more layers on top of it, and then when I change my windshield, I change.
You swap it out.
So I guess next thing we need to do is go cut some 1/4-inch black stripes.
Okay. Okay, guys. So what we've done is we finished up this door. We're going to heat shrink it still, but the tape job is completely done here. And I thought about maybe going along here and putting another window. Because this is the thin Lexan, the thinnest you can get. The previous owner wanted to keep the weight down, and it makes it a little bit, a little soft. I thought about maybe putting a bar in here, and then put a lower window, and that would almost give it like a helicopter kind of look. That'd be kind of cool if you had, a bar going in, and then rivet that in, and then put that tape over that. So, who's calling me? People call me when I'm doing videos. And cut. Okay, guys, sorry about that interruption. So I wanted to just to show you kind of where we wound up here with the doors, and we'll be starting on the windshield next. And so this is probably going to become a two-parter on the recording, because I need to shrink down. How about I do this? Hold on. There you go. This will probably become a two-parter, because we want to finish the other door and then start on the windshield. And we've got a little bit of work to do around that cap that goes on the windshield. That's not on there yet, so we want to be sure we get that situated. So join us for part number deuce, and we'll see you here at the Bean Patch remotely at Jim Robinson's Erie Airpark in beautiful but very rainy downtown Erie. All right, guys, be blessed. We'll see you on the next video.